Christ of the Covenants, Session 69, 诸约中的基督第六十九讲 ,Page 274, 第274页。我们开始了第十三章，上帝透过基督所立的约，完结的约。现在我们来看耶利米书第三十一章的预言的广义的背景 ,Context, 里面有七个主题。第一个主题，上次我们讲过了，就是被掳的以色列民呢必定会归回到应许之地。我们来现在来考虑第二个主题。Full restoration of God's blessing on the land of promise. 上帝完全恢复对应许之地的赐福。The curses of the old covenant, left the land of God's people scorched and barren. 旧的约的咒诅呢让上帝子民的地焚烧枯干 But according to the provisions of the everlasting covenant 但是根据永远的约所预备的 Fields are to be bought Which once were declared a desolation as a result of the Babylonian invasion 巴比伦人来攻打的时候地都荒凉了现在他们要把这些地买回来耶利米三十二章四十三节 The city of Jerusalem shall be rebuilt for the Lord 耶路撒冷城必定为耶和华的缘故被重建 The whole valley polluted by dead bodies shall become holy to the Lord 整个被尸体污染的山谷要分别为圣归于耶和华耶利米书第三十一章三十八到四十节 The resurrectional activity of the Spirit of God in the Valley of Dry Bones attaches to the provisions of the everlasting covenant according to Ezekiel 根据以西结的预言呢永远的约所预备的乃是上帝的灵在、在骸骨的山谷里做复活的工作参考以西结三十七章十二和二十六节 God will open the graves of Israel cause them to come alive 上帝要把以色列的坟墓打开让骸骨活过来 and so will bring them into their land 这样子领他们回到他们的地以西结三十七章第十二节 He will put his spirit within them making the deadto live 上帝必定将他的灵放在他们里面死人必活过来 Both Jeremiah and Ezekiel in the passages cited above relate the restoration of the land to this resurrection motif 我们上面所指的耶利米书跟以西结书的经文呢都把归回到应许之地和复活这两个主题连在一起的Not merely those who happen to be alive at the time of the institution of the new covenant shall experience the blessings of restoration of the land. 经历到归回到应许之地的不仅仅是那些在设立新的约的时候活着的人。Instead, 不是的。The dead shall be brought to life so that they too may participate in the complete renovation accomplished.By the new covenant, 死人必定活过来，他们就在新的约所成就的完全的万事的复兴上有份。Number three, 第三个主题 ,divine fulfillment of previous covenantal commitments, 上帝要兑现他先前在约里面所做过的承诺。A third motif associated with the New Covenant prophecy of Jeremiah relates this consummating covenant to God's previous covenantal commitments. 耶利米关于新的约的预言里面有第一个第三个主题，就是这个完结的约呢，与上帝先前在约里面的承诺是有关的。By the New Covenant, God shall fulfill all the promises of the covenant established earlier with his people.上帝借着新的约要实现 他先前与他的子民所设立的约里面的所有的应许 The obedience to God's law, which did not materialize under the Mosaic covenant, shall find consummate fulfillment under the provisions of the new covenant. 在摩西的约之下，遵行上帝的律法并没有实现出来，但是在新的约里有着一个至终的完结性的实现。耶利米31:33, Israel's possession of the land promised to Abraham shall become a solid and unshakable reality. 以色列必定拥有上帝应许给亚伯拉罕的地，这个会是一个坚固的不动摇的事实。Ezekiel particularly emphasizes the fulfillment of the previous covenantal promises through the new covenant. 以西结特别强调借着新的约上帝会实现先前约里面的应许的。David shall be king over Israel. 大卫必定做以色列民的王。The nation shall walk according to the statutes of the Mosaic covenant. 全国必定根据摩西的约的律例典章行事为人。The people shall live on the land promised to Jacob. 民必住在上帝应许给雅各之地的。以西结书37:24-25. The blessings associated with the new covenant, therefore, cannot be regarded as a development of perspective previously unknown to God's people. 因此，整个新的约里，上帝要赐的福分呢，这个角度呢，肯定不是神的子民以前不认识的，不是的。Instead, this covenant shall bring to fruition the redemptive intentions of God's displayed throughout the ages. 反之，这个新的约呢，会实现上帝在历世历代里的救赎的计划，就是前面的三个月里面的用意心意。Number four, 第四个主题 ，internal renewal by the work of God's Spirit. 上帝的灵内在的更新工作，在人心里面内在的更新的工作。Unique to the administration of the new covenant, according to Jeremiah, will be the internalized inscription of the law of God. 根据耶利米，新的约的一个独特的执行的方法，乃是上帝律法必定会刻在人的内心里面。The heart of flesh belonging to the members of the covenant community shall serve as the tablets on which the Torah shall be inscribed. 新的约的群众的成员将会有一个肉的心，这个肉的心就是好像石板，一块石板一样，神的律法要刻在这个心上。耶利米31:33. Other passages speak of God's putting his fear in the hearts of his people so that they will not turn away from him. 其他的经文论到上帝要在他的子民心里面放一个敬畏之心，好叫他们不会再偏离他。耶利米书32:40. Of putting his spirit within them, 上帝必将他的灵放在他们心里面。以西结37:14. And of the Lord cleansing them, 耶和华必定洁净他们。以西结37:23. Jeremiah declares that in this coming redemption, God's people no more shall walk after the stubbornness of their hearts. 耶利米宣告，将来神的救赎来临的时候，神的子民不再按照他们顽梗的心而行。耶利米3:17. The new covenant therefore boasts a unique feature in its power to transform its participants from within their hearts. 因此，新的约有一个独特的特点，就是大有能力的约的成员从内心改变。This uniqueness sets the new covenant apart from the previous covenantal dealings of God with his people. 新的约因为有这个特质，因此呢，与前面上帝与他的子民所立的约呢，有所不同。 Number five, 第五个主题 ,the full forgiveness of sins, 罪完全被赦免。Closely associated with a renewed heart of covenantal participation is the pardon of all sins. 那么在这个新的约里面有份得到新的心，与这两者有关的就是一切的罪必定被赦免。This forgiveness is preserved as a foundational principle in the primary New Covenant passage in Jeremiah. 罪的赦免呢，在耶利米书三十一章三十四节这个最主要的新的约的经文里面是一个基础性的原则。The prophet elsewhere declares in connection with the everlasting covenant that search will be made for the iniquity of Israel, but no sin will be found. 耶利米书在其他的地方，特别是第五十章第二十节呢，宣告在永恒的约里，上帝会寻找以色列的罪孽，但是找不到的。God will cleanse the people of their iniquities, hardening them fully. 上帝会洁净他的子民，除去一切的罪孽，完全的赦免他们的。耶利米三十三章第八节。The uniqueness of this pardon of all iniquity in the new covenant, as it might compare with forgiveness under the earlier covenant, will be discussed subsequently. 我们在下文会讨论到，所有的罪孽的赦免，这个是新的约的一个特点，与先前的约的赦免是有所不同的，我们下文会讨论。 Suffice it to say at this point, 我们现在只指出一点，就是 that the forgiveness of sin serves as a central feature in prophetic anticipations of the new covenant. 那先知预期新约的时候呢，罪的赦免是一个主要的核心性的主题。 Number six, 第六个主题 The union of Israel and Judah, 以色列和犹大的联合。 The new covenant will not be made only with a portion of God's people. 上帝不是跟他的子民的一部分设立新约的。 Instead, a hallmark of the new covenant will be the merging of the kingdoms of Israel and Judah.新的约其中一个特点就是以色列跟犹大两个王国会合而为一。Jeremiah specifically relates the promise to both the nations. 耶利米呢特别说这个应许是指两国的。耶利米三十一章三十一节 Israel shall come together with the sons of Judah seeking the Lord. 以色列必与犹大的后裔一同的寻求耶和华。耶利米第五十章第四节 As Ezekiel develops his prophetic vision of the everlasting covenant of peace, he speaks of the reunion of the two sticks that have been separated from one another. 当以西结发挥那个永恒的平安之约的意象的时候，他说的两根的枝子呢，会再次联合。参考以西结三十七章十五和十六节 One shepherd king of the Davidic line shall rule over the reunited nation. 两国必合而为一。大卫的后裔牧人君王要统治这个国。以西结三十四章二十三节 As the people of God are bound in a new covenant to the God of the covenant, so they are bound inseparably with one another. 正如上帝的子民在新的约里面与盟约的神联系在一起，同样的他们也是彼此联合了。最后 number seven, 第七个主题 The everlasting character of the new covenant 新的约是永恒之约。 Essential to a full appreciation of the distinctiveness of the new covenant is an awareness of its everlasting character.新的约有这个永恒的性质，这个对体会新约的独特性是必须有的。Indeed, this characteristic had been assigned to previous divine administrations. 诚然，这个永恒的特点呢，在上帝先前执行约的时候是存在的。The Abrahamic covenant is characterized as everlasting. 上帝与亚伯兰所立的约是永远的约。创世纪十七章第七节。诗篇105篇第十节 As is the Mosaic 与摩西所立的约也是永远的。出埃及记四十章十五节，利未记十六章三十四节，利未记二十四章八节和以赛亚书二十四章第五节。And Davidic 与大卫所设立的约也是一样。撒母耳记下第七章十三和十六节，诗篇八十九篇三和四节，还有诗篇一百三十二十一跟十二节。But the everlasting character of the new covenant seems to imply an eschatological dimension. 但是新的约是永恒的，这个性质就暗示着这个新的约是个末世的约。Eschatological. It is not only the new covenant, it is the last covenant. 新的约不单单是新的约，也是最后的约。Because it shall bring to full fruition that which God intends in redemption, it never shall be superseded by a subsequent covenant. 因为在新的约里，上帝在救赎计划里面的心意会完完全全的实现，因此新的约之后不会有另外一个约来超越它。Men shall come to Zion to join themselves to the Lord in an everlasting covenant that will not be forgotten. 人会一起来到锡安山，在永远的约里面与上帝与耶和华联合，这个约永远不会被忘记。耶利米五十章第五节， God's previous covenants may be regarded as everlasting only insofar as they find their realization in a new covenant. 上帝先前的诸约可以说是永远的约，只因为他们都在新的约里面最后实现了。It is essential to see the new covenant prophecy of Jeremiah in this total biblical theological setting. 我们必须要从这个整体的圣经神学的架构里面去看，去理解耶利米对新的约的预言。 Although the term new covenant occurs only in Jeremiah 31. 是的，新的约这个词汇只有在耶利米第三十一章出现。 The complex of ideas depicting the future expectation of God's people has a very broad base. 但是关于上帝子民未来的展望的一组合的概念呢，它有一个很广大的基础的。 Essentially, it may be said, 基本上我们可以这样说， that the future age is characterized by the prophets as having a covenantal structure. 未来的时代有着一个盟约的架构， corresponding to the whole of God, the Lord's past dealings with his people.就等于上帝过去所有对待他的子民的方法都带着约的架构。 While maintaining a balance of continuity with the past, this new covenant possesses unique features belong to it alone. 一方面新的约与过去的约有着一个连续性，但是同时有它的独特的地方。By this covenant, the intentions of God to redeem a people to himself shall find consummate fulfillment. 上帝借着这个新的约呢，最后实现了他的心意，就是他必定为自己救赎他的子民。好，所以上面我们讲了七个耶利米跟以西结等等预言的主题。现在来到本章的第二部分。Specific context of Jeremiah 31. 耶利米书第三十一章的狭义的背景。Before considering in detail the teaching of Jeremiah 31, 31 to 34 concerning the new covenant, 当我们还没有探索到耶利米书第三十一章三十一到三十四节的细节的时候， some attention must be given to questions respecting the literary character and context of this prophecy. 我们必须注意到这段经文的文字上的特点和它的背景。 It is not possible to reconstruct absolutely the process by which a passage such as Jeremiah 31, 31 to 34 arrived in its present form and context in the book of Jeremiah. 耶利米书第31章31到34节这段经文呢，是怎么样在这经过了怎么一个的过程，在最后在耶利米书里面出现的话，那我们不可能重建这个过程。 It probably is correct to say that the passage originally was a unit to itself. 若说这段经文先前是一个独立的单元，这样说可能是正确的。Although the precise framework of the unit is difficult to determine, 但是这个独立的单元是用什么架构去理解呢？那就不容易决定了。Presently, the New Covenant prophecy appears in a collection of declarations based on a common theme, having to do with the promise of the Lord for the restoration of Israel beyond its devastation. 现在，在耶利米书31章的关于新约的预言呢，出现在一系列的宣告的里面。这系列的宣告呢，有一个共同的主题，就是上帝应许必定在以色列被毁之后恢复他们。 The theme binding together the prophecies of Jeremiah 30 and 31 is indicated plainly in the first three verses of chapter 30.
耶利米第30跟31章这两章的预言的共同主题呢，很清楚的在第30章的第一二三节指出。
The prophet is told to write the words of the Lord has spoken to him in a book.
主吩咐先知把他对先知所讲的话写在书上。
For the Lord would restore the fortunes of his people.
因为耶和华必定使他的子民恢复到他们的蒙福的地位。
The two chapters are bound together not only by the common theme, but also by a common introductory phrase.
这两章不单单是因为他们有着共同的主题而联系在一起的，他们有共同的一个导言。
For behold, days are coming, says Yahweh.
耶和华说，看啊，日子必到。耶利米30章第3节，31章27节，31和38节。
These chapters have been called the grand hymn of Israel's deliverance.
这两章呢，被称为以色列得救的伟大的诗歌。
These chapters represent the one of the high watermarks of biblical prophecies of hope.
我们可以说这两章呢，代表着旧约先知的盼望的高潮之一。
The date of this particular prophecy cannot be determined.
我们不能确定说这两章的预言的日期。
It is not necessary to assume that the captivity of 587 BC already has occurred.
我们不必假设主前587年的被掳是已经发生了。
That the prophet experienced so much personal anguish at the hands of his fellow Israelites because of his consistent emphasis on the inescapable captivity of Judah, it certainly is not difficult to imagine him also looking beyond the abyss of devastation and offering some word of hope to his people.
假如先知们呢，假如先知在以色列他的以色列同胞手中经历到这些的痛苦，都因为他不断的强调犹大被掳是不能逃脱的，那么我们不难想象他会在这个毁灭的深渊的另一面会看到他会为他的子民带来一些希望的信息的。好，现在我们来到本章的第三部分，我们下一章开始讲 第三部分 Exegetical Observations， 解经方面的三方面的观察。我们休息一分钟。